Welcome back to my YouTube channel Remedial Classes. Today I have come up with a new chapter, Lost Spring by Annice Jung. Annice Jung, she was born in Rourkela and spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. Later she moved to United States of America for higher studies. This story is an excerpt from her book Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Excerpt means a small part. So let's begin the story, Lost Spring. First of all, we would like to know, what do you understand by spring? Spring is the most beautiful part of the season, where flowers bloom, where birds sing, where we see greenery all around. So the earth is filled with colors, fragrance and beauty. So when we compare it with our life, it is the most childhood days is known as spring in human life. During childhood days, we are carefree and free from all the burdens of life. We play, we sing, we run, we study. This is the base where our later days are based on. So let's start the story. Lost Spring has two parts. The first part is, sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage, and the second part is, I want to drive a car. Both these parts deals with the perpetual poverty and child labor. So in the first part, the author gives a description about Saheb, the boy who is a rag picker, and from where he has come. Actually, Saheb and his family, they were originally from Dhaka. Their house were in the midst of greenery. They had beautiful paddy fields, but due to a storm which swept away everything, and so they had to move around in different part of the cities for gold. Gold means survival. So Saheb is a rag picker, and the author, she often encounters him on the way and sees him scrounging for something in the garbage dumps. So the author asks him, why do you do this? Simply, the boy said that, I have nothing else to do. His voice was low. Then the author said, why don't you go to school? He said that, there is no school in our neighborhood. So the author said, if I open a school, would you come and join? He said, definitely. So after some days, again Saheb saw the author. He ran toward her and told her that, you said that you are building a school. Where is it? Did you build it? The author felt shy within, and she was sorry that she made a hollow promise. So she said that, it takes time to build a school. But inwardly she was very sorry, and she was thinking that there are people around who make false promises to such types of children, and they never fulfill their promise. Next, the author moves on saying that she calls these boys a group of barefooted soldiers who wanders in the morning like flocks of birds, but in the afternoon they disappear. One day she asks Saheb, what is your name? Then he says, his name is Saheb-e-Alam. You know, it is an ironical statement. Saheb-e-Alam means Lord of the Universe, but this boy is a rag picker. He does not even know the meaning of his name. Ironical statement means when we say something, it is completely contrary to the meaning. Okay, where means it is said Lord of the Universe, but he is a rag picker, so there is a huge contrast and the meaning is totally opposite. Then the author said that, why do you scrunch in the garbage dumps? Saheb said, I find a rupee, I find a coin, or sometimes 10 rupee notes. So he said that silver coin means 1 rupee note he finds sometimes, or 10 rupees. His eyes were glittering, means they were so happy that they find a rupee in the garbage dumps. Again, the author asked some of the boys who were standing there, she asked to one of them, why don't you wear chappals? He said that my mother kept it up in the shelf. And the other replied that even if his mother brings them down, he will not wear it. That boy was wearing shoes that was also of opposite. Both the shoes were also not matching. And the third one says that, I have never wore shoes in my life. I want shoes. Here the author again connects it with the tradition, because most of the time people do not wear shoes, and they connect it with their tradition that barefoot is a part of their tradition. But actually it is not. In order to hide their perpetual poverty, or they have no money to buy, that is why they simply said it is an excuse that they say that we don't wear shoes. Next, the author remembers that sometime back there was a boy from UDP whose father was a priest. On his way to school, he would pray to the God for a pair of shoes. So after 30 years, when the author visited the same place, it had become totally deserted, but at the backyard there were new houses constructed and there the boys wore shoes. But there were many children around who do not wear shoes even these days, the author said. So ultimately, making friendship with the small boys, one day she felt like moving on to their house where they live, so which led her to Simhapuri. The ragpickers live in Simhapuri, a periphery of Delhi, that means outskirt Delhi. Here 10,000 ragpickers lives without sewage, without drinking water, without electricity, and they have no other work to do, only ragpicking. So it is metaphorically, the author says that though it is in Delhi, it is far away from Delhi. Their houses were made of thatched roofs, which was made of tin or tarpaulin, and the condition was really deplorable. So she said metaphor means a literary device, which means direct comparison. Like let me give you an example. Like if I say she is as beautiful as a rose, it is a simile, but when I say she is a rose, it is a metaphor. So Simhapuri is Delhi, but it is far away, because though it is metaphorically it is in Delhi, but it is totally different. Where is Delhi, the capital of India, where there is all sorts of facility available, drinking water, electricity, sewage, drainage, what not, and the people lives a very good quality life. But in the same place, a bit outskirt, people are living totally a very poor and deplorable life. So the author asks some of the ladies who were wearing tattered sarees. So one of them, when she asked that why did you leave Dhaka, she said that Dhaka, we had a very good fields, but due to flood which swept away our everything, by living there, if we have no food, what is the use? So we have come to the city in search of food. So here, though we do not have any identity, we do not have any jobs, but only with the help of ration card, they get some rations and voters, and they can cast their vote. It is also the politicians, for their benefit only given them the ration card so that they can get the vote. But in reality, they do not do anything for these poor people. But this lady, they have no problem. They said that if we can fill our stomach at night, and if we go without an aching stomach, that is much for us. We don't need any identity. So now, next, moving on to the story, the author says that one day she sees the boy. She sees the boy scrounging for something in the garbage dumps. Then she asked, "Why are you scrounging?" Then this boy said that, Sahib said that, sometimes I get a silver coin, that means 1 rupee note, or sometimes I get 10 rupee note. So this garbage for the children is wrapped in wonder. They try to find out something. If they get some money, they are very happy. But it is different for the elderly people, because the elderly people, for them, it is a means of survival through which they can run their family. Now next, moving on to the story, the narrator says that one day she sees Saheb peeping through the fence of a club where two people were playing tennis. He was wearing shoes. The shoes were also discarded one of some rich boy, but he was very happy wearing the shoes. A boy who had never wore shoes in his life, how happy he might be by getting these shoes. And then he was watching the game through the fence. The author said, what are you looking at? He said that I love tennis, so I am watching. When the players will go away, I would go inside. The gatekeeper allows me to go inside and enjoy the swing. So the author was thinking that this game, this tennis game is out of reach for this poor boy because the tennis is played only by the rich people of the society. Next, moving on, the author says that one day she sees Saheb carrying a canister. Okay, then canister means a utensil for carrying milk or tea. Then the author asks him, what do you do these days? Then he said that I am working in a tea stall. The author asks, how much are you paid? He said that I am paid 800 rupees with all the meals. But still, the carefree look was not there on his face. He was very sad because now he is not the owner of his work. Though he is happy carrying the rack picking luggage, the plus polythene which he carries on his back. Though the polythene is much more heavier than this canister, but still he is happy because in carrying the polythene bag, the rags, he is happy because he is his own master. But carrying this canister booth, he is not his own master. Somebody else is his master. So here ends the story. It shows the perpetual state of poverty, and also it shows how these people had accepted their fate, and they do not think of dreaming something big other than garbage dumps or rag picking. So
if you like the video, please do share and subscribe. Thank you.